Continuing our build up to basketball here on the SEC Network, how about the Tennessee Lady Vols ranked number 15 in the preseason AP poll? Kellie Harper coming back for her third season. Of course, she was a player at Tennessee, won 3 national titles, hoping to get the Lady Vols back into that national stage, Drea.
Yeah, and with that, we bring in Lady Vol legend, point guard, the star, and the head coach, Kellie Harper. Thank you so much for joining us, hanging out with us. How has the team looked this offseason? What stood out to you, Coach?
Well, it's been fun. We've had a lot of energy. I think that happens when you have several new players. We have 5 new faces on the team, and so it's a lot of newness. They have been so coachable, given us great effort, and a lot of excitement.
Coach, talk to us about some of those new players. Some of them coming from high school, a couple of them transfers. Who do we need to know? What are the names that we need to keep an eye open when the season starts?
Yeah, so we have 4 freshmen. Kaya Wynn, Brooklyn Miles, both guards, quick, bring some athleticism on the perimeter. Caroline Striplin and Sarah Puckett bring more size, versatility. They can shoot out on the floor. They can post up. They can do a lot of different things. Sarah's skill set has really stood out in this preseason. And then our transfer, Alexis Dye, coming from Troy, where she was a terrific player of the year, actually, in her league. She's coming in with about 7 championship rings, so she's a winner, and she's going to make an immediate impact on our program.
7 rings.
Yeah, it's amazing. Coach, I want to talk just a little bit more about Alexis Dye, and then obviously get into some of your returners. But with Alexis, when you talk about replacing Renaya Davis, statistically, the numbers are very similar. You know, Alexis Dye pretty much averaged a double-double last season, but her game is different than Renaya's. So how would you describe Alexis's game and kind of how she's going to fit in this season?
Well, I think she has the size of our guards, basically in the league, and our guards here on our team. She's primarily played more of a small forward, so more of a 4 type position in the past. So we've worked really hard on developing her guard skills, not just for our team, but for her future as well. But you're going to see her slide in that 3-4 spot. She doesn't play like Renaya, but she gives you great athleticism. She is great on the boards. And I think what we're going to try to do, instead of fitting her into our little box, we're going to make sure that we are utilizing our player strengths, and they're different every year. And I think we're going to be able to utilize her in the open court. She runs the floor well, half court offense, maybe put her around the high post area. I think she's going to really thrive there.
When it comes to players, Coach, that Tennessee fans know and love already, the Ray Burrells, the Jordan Horstons, who are coming back this year, what do you anticipate from them? How has their game gotten better from when they got on campus to this year?
Well, I think Ray Burrell coming back in, she still looks really good. Physically, I think she's pushing herself even a little bit more. She's shooting the ball well. She can really score. I mean, she can take a lot on and go get a bucket. Jordan Horston looks a lot more confident. She walks on the court with a veteran presence now that may not have had in the past. And then Tamari Key, you know, being able to be a force inside both offensively and defensively will still be big for us.
And I know it's obviously really early, Coach, but just from seeing this team, what do you anticipate the identity being? What are some pillars of this team that you kind of want to build on and have steady as the season goes on?
I think our depth will be really important, that we're playing a lot of people. I think our grittiness, our toughness, I think we're going to be really aggressive. And those are things that I want to see that are really it's this team's personality. So the aggressiveness on both ends of the court. Rebounding will forever and always be important here. I don't know if that's just me or me being a Tennessee girl. You know, I mean, you had to rebound or you weren't playing here. And I've carried that through my coaching career and obviously emphasize it still with this team.
And then, Coach, we have to end. Obviously, there are 2 Lady Vol greats that just recently won a WNBA championship in Candace Parker and Diamond DeShields. Just how big is that for Lady Vols for life, and how can you kind of use that to inspire this season's team?
Actually, I used it at our last practice. Talked to our team about adversity. Talked to our team about how those players picked each other up, how things They played to their strengths when I thought when the Sky was winning, they were doing things that the Sky needed to do to be successful. And, you know, we talked about it quite a bit. It was very inspiring. Our players, you know, they understand that sisterhood. They understand those are our people. You know, that's our family. And we talked about it quite a bit, and they're pulling for them.
I just got chills.
My heart started beating fast there, Coach. I feel it too. Best of luck this season. We'll be watching.
All right, thanks a lot.